$20 million, that's the amount that California taxpayers will pay to kidnap and rape victim Jaycee Dugard and her daughters. State lawmakers approved that payout today. It includes a settlement between the Department of Corrections and Dugard.
Jaycee kidnapped at age 11 and held for 18 years, allegedly by a state parolee. KCR3's Lindsay Paula with details and reaction to this huge settlement.
Well, Walt, that settlement was reached in mediation led by a retired San Francisco Superior Court judge. While neither the Department of Corrections or the representatives of the Dugard family are commenting on it today, one legal expert told us $20 million is a good deal for the state.
Jaycee Dugard has been free since last August when she resurfaced after 18 years in captivity. Authorities say Philip and Nancy Garrido kidnapped and raped her, holding her for nearly two decades. The Garridos have pleaded not guilty. Dugard and her family filed a claim with the State Victims Compensation Fund, saying the State Department of Corrections failed to supervise Garrido while he was a state parolee and to find Dugard. She claimed negligence by the department and personal extreme emotional distress. Dugard settled with the Department of Corrections for $20 million. Lawmakers approved that settlement today.
It's, a real recognition and acknowledgement of what a terrible, terrible situation the family finds itself in, and hopefully this will go towards the counseling, health care, education, everything that's going to be necessary, clearly, for a lifetime.
Neither side will say how they reached the magic number. McGeorge Law Professor John Meyer says it's a lot of money, but it does not shock him.
The state could not litigate this case. It would be a public relations disaster, even if they won. So it makes complete sense for the state to settle this. It's the right thing to do legally and morally, whether the state did anything wrong or not.
While the state could have argued to have the case thrown out, Meyer says that would have been risky. It's cheaper to settle.
It was a way to make reparations, to do the right thing by this family, and also to shut off liability. And both are legitimate state interests.
Now coming up tonight at 6 o'clock, we're going to have reaction from crime victim advocates as well as taxpayers, because taxpayers are the ones who will foot the bill.
Well, there you go. There's $20 million. The state obviously has no money. So how do we pay for that, and when will she get the money?
Department of Finance tells us it's kind of an interesting formula, but basically that money will come from the general fund. And right now, since we do not have a budget, they will have to wait until we have a 2010-2011 budget approved. Then the money will come from the general fund. That hole that's left in the general fund will be replaced by the rainy day fund money. So there's, $1.2 billion in reserve, and that will cover that.
So Jaycee waiting for her money, as a lot of state workers. Everybody's got waiting for the situation to be rectified.
Lindsay,
thank you.
So what do you think of the state's $20 million settlement with Jaycee Dugard and her family? Is it too much, not enough, or she shouldn't get a payout? You can log on to KCRA.com to vote in our survey. And already we are getting dozens of comments on our Facebook page. Ellie Allen says there is no amount of money that could make up for what that family went through. Dominique Ferguson doesn't seem as sure, saying nothing can make up for what has happened to Jaycee Dugard, but the state of California handing her money doesn't seem right to me somehow. And David Kaminga says he feels for her, but has this question. Someone tell me why taxpayers are giving her the money. What did we do to her? You can post your thoughts on Facebook.com/KCRA3.